My name is Unite the Clans, and today we are going to build 10 small houses and turn this into this. What is going on, guys? Unite the Clans here, back in your life, and today it's just me and you. The collabs lately have been fun. Did the usual ones with Nick and Chris. Went and got Swamp Fever with my man Kane83, and then did a little gladiatorial combat with my new friends, the Lame Wolves. I'm really excited to have those guys on the server. In fact, I helped get them on this server. I put in a good word for them and pushed us to look to add them. And now they're here. I'm happy they are, but I gotta be honest, their base, I was over there and it put me to shame a little. They've only been on a few days and they have some gigantic buildings, and they have a ton of them. So we're gonna get ourselves started, guys, with building up this place. And we're gonna do so, I think, with a combination of stone and wood for this part. I want this island to be a village. So my plan is the closer you get to the tops of the hills where we'll have our giant builds, we'll do stone buildings, and then wood as we move further down, and then thatch buildings closer to the beach. That feels like a good system, but we're gonna get ourselves started with this one. It's just a simple 2x2, and I'm just gonna build it on the fly. I've not made any plans. I did a few small, simple builds today, just to kind of get the feel in and get some ideas of what might work. I'm gonna throw these in so that we can do pillars on the corners. These are your simple fence foundations. And I think we'll just throw some pillars on each corner. And we'll see how this looks. I think we're gonna use wood to do these walls, maybe even wood roofs on this place. But we'll have enough stone between the pillars and the foundations to make this look like a bit of a beefy building. And I think we're gonna go into a second story with this one. So let's go ahead and pillar up. Why don't I hammer out this build, guys, and I'll come back to you, because I want to tackle like 10 of them today. So I'll handle this one, and I'm gonna come back to you when I got it looking kind of good. Now that I think about it, 10 builds in an episode may be crazy, so let's just do what we can do, guys. I got an interesting idea for this one. I started off with windows and door frames on the bottom level. I think we're gonna go with the solid walls on this next level, but I got a plan to introduce a third level to this build. Now, this is the first one we're tackling in this episode, I wanna make sure that it's a good one. So let's get ourselves in here, and I've got wooden ceilings. And I think what we're gonna do, we'll see how well this works, but I think we're gonna try and do that over the pillar type placement. And we'll do that all around, so I think that's gonna require eight. Let's do windows up above. No, I don't like that. Let's get back the... Oh no, I didn't make enough. Okay, we're doing the windows. The wooden windows for above the door here. And is that still gonna go in place? There's too many freaking snap points now. Oh, I got it. Perfect. Yeah, it's good to try and get one level done before you start on the next. Otherwise, your snap points get messed right up. But we're just gonna... Oh, you did something weird up there. Let's see. Let's see if I can get them all going the same way. I wonder why that one did that. Let's go here. Yeah, it really wants to place like that. Well, let's get the ones in that are going the right way, and we'll see what we can do. See, that one wants to go funky, super funky. That one works, okay. That's going a weird way. Okay, maybe we got some stuff going weird ways. It must have something to do with the pillars. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, let's just go ahead and do it. It's not going to be super integral to the design that we've got on the go here. And you know what? I think I didn't want to put one in the middle, so let's go ahead and wreck that. Yep, perfect. And... can I make another? I can't make another. Shoot. Should have brought more resources. But what I'm going to do is go ahead and put the foundations on the corners again, if I got a few of those left. This is going to look a little weird. It might turn out cool. But let's go ahead and put one of those there and try the pillar on the corner. Oh, that can't go higher. Okay, well, we'll just deal with what we can deal with. Is that gonna look too strange? That might look too strange. Okay, let's not mess around with that. And I'll take down the foundation too. And then what we're gonna do is have this overhang, and then we're gonna do a stone, one story of stone on the second level, which I think is gonna look pretty good. So it's gonna look something like, ooh, I didn't make enough of these either. But I'll cut away to finish up this build here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this and this and one more, and then you're gonna get a real idea of it. So I think that's my rough plan, and then I'll figure out a way to do a sloped roof in this place, on the top of this place as well. All right, so this first one is coming together. I hope you like. I've sort of just kind of been inspired as I've gone. Oh, did I not make enough? What a dang fool. Okay, well, we'll continue as best we can for now, and I'll finish this up. But what I'm gonna do with this one, guys, is go ahead and place these on the corners like that. I'll do one. No, that's not right. I'll do one there, and obviously I do one over here as well. And then, actually, you know what? I'm rethinking the whole thing. Let's do it with the wood. I think that's gonna look best, and then we'll do. Yes. Okay. Perfect. I think I'm all over this. I got a plan. Hatch frame? I made one of those. Yeah. Okay. So let's just see if I can make a stone window wall. I definitely can't. I don't have any stone in my inventory. No problem. But maybe I can after I replace these. So I'm gonna do one of these. So I'll have wood again up top, and I think that's gonna look cool. And I'm leaving a hole in the middle of this because my plan for the top roof is to have the hatch frame in it. So that will. Whoops. Nope. Keep picking the wrong thing. There we go. But that will allow some of the natural light to kind of come through. So this is gonna look good, I think. And we're gonna fill in the gap in the middle with more of this window wall. So let's go ahead and throw those in there. Nice to do some building. Nice to be back to just recording all by my lonesome. Every once in a while. Oh, that's. These are on. No? Okay. I might be crazy. That looked weird for a bit, but I think it's gonna work for us. So let me try now that I've got some stone. I still don't think it's enough. I think I'm gonna need 60, 35. Okay, cool. Well, we will get there. So I'll throw another one of these window frames on this side, and how the roof is gonna look. I can do all but the last couple pieces of it. It's gonna look like this. Yeah, that is off. There's a weird building grid thing happening there. I think it's my fault. Clearly, it's my fault. I built this building. But then we're going to do the flat across the top here. And then in the middle, instead of doing another one of those, let's go ahead and do the hatch frame. So you get a little bit of natural light, it'll come down all the way onto your main floor. I'll do the same thing that I did on this side, on the other side, and I'll gather some supplies for the next build. We're going to tackle this episode, and we'll see how it turns out. The mornings in Ark are so freaking gorgeous. I love it. I'm going to have to remember to adjust my gamma as we go forward, but dang, that's beautiful. And that's the house, guys. That's the one that we started off with. I'm wondering if I should have done a full second story on the upper level, but I kind of like the way it turned out. Run the pillars all the way to the ground, do the bottom in wood, the top in stone, except for the dormers, the sloped roofs, and the center part up there. We did those in wood, and if you wander inside, you see. Actually, I can always put a ladder on this too. I brought one just in case we need it, but I'll throw a ladder. Can we do it in the middle? Yes, we can. I'll put one right there. You can climb up. You could always have a little area up here. This is actually a pretty decent size. If you wanted to, you could do the hatch frame right here as well, and then you'd have a full 3x3 second floor. little natural light from above. This was the first one, so I wanted to make sure we did something dramatic and did a good one, but we're gonna see how many we can get done in this episode, guys. So let's go ahead and throw a couple doors in and call this build complete. I think I like the way it looks. The next one, let's take a look, because I want to get a good screenshot out of all this too. So how about we go just up the hill one here, and we'll do another simple one right about here. I'm going to do the stone foundations. I honestly think they're the best looking foundations in the game. They're not hollow. They go pretty much all the way to the ground. That one's not quite all the way down, but I think no matter what you're building, this is often the best bet, even if it's a simple wood house. So I like to make sure the doors are accessible. You're not going to have a deck or a porch on this. So let's go ahead and do a door here on the end. Yeah, I think that's going to work perfect. And we'll just throw this one in. Guys, this one's going to be super quick compared to the last time. So I'll do one there, and I'll do another windowed one on the back. And then we'll use just regular walls to fill in. I like to mix it up. Oh, I must have done that wrong. We'll mix it up, and I think that's how that's going to look. Yeah, pretty simple. Now, the question of how to do the roof is always a key one. When I have a 2x1 build, I usually like to keep it simple, and I'll often just do a simple sloped roof where you say put a piece here, and then you put another piece like that, and that's it. And as you can see what I, or sorry, you can totally see what I did up there where I did the stone, but in the awning, I did a different material. And I think we're going to do the same thing with this one. So wood build, but we are going to do the stone, and I think we're going to do the reverse of the stone so you get the wood texture on it. Yeah, I think that's going to look solid. So you just have to press, I think for me it's Q, for most people the default is E, but it's going to look like that. And that's the same texture that you get on the inside of the stone walls, which I don't know if you can see up in there, but yeah, it's got wood on the back, so you can kind of create a little bit of a Tudor style effect with that. So I'm going to go ahead and put this one on this side and flip it, and they naturally show their outer texture first. So once you flip it once, you're getting the inner texture. I don't think I brought a door. We might have enough supplies for one. Let's see. Yes, even a reinforced door. So let's make one of those because we haven't used those yet today. And I like a little variety. So we'll go ahead and put that on here. And I think this is an easy enough entrance. You can just walk in. Perfect. So to finish this build, I think we're going to do some wood. And that is exactly the same setup as before. Oh, there's a couple different spots for it. So just be careful. And I think that's because I flipped those. So ooh, it's either going to be off-center one way or off-center the other way. Let's off-center towards the downhill, because that's where we, that's, I don't know, it doesn't really matter. But because I flipped them, they're not quite on center. And then you want to make sure this is lined up. That looks pretty lined up. Close enough for me not to care. And that's it, guys. There's your second house. Pretty simple. If you're not going to put anything inside, I'd recommend doing the window, open and closable windows so that it looks a little more closed up. But that's how it looks from this side. And I really like that combination of stone, wood, foundations, walls, sloped walls, and then the ceiling. And that's kind of what we did here. We did stone, wood, stone. So I've been mixing it up like that a lot lately, and that does look so off-center. Whatever, I can live with it. So let me gather some resources for a third house. Maybe we'll do one a little further up the hill. And yeah, that's perfect. We're going to do this one right about here. And because we're getting further up the hill, I want to use even more stone. So we're going to go pretty much all stone and maybe just a wood or a thatch roof. Something a little different with some variety. And when you get those next to some of the other builds I've done on the island, like this is like the first version I built of my Snowy River cabin, this place is going to start to look villagey. And you can see some of the foundations I got laid out. We have got plenty of 2x1 buildings because those are super easy and simple to construct, and they're going to make this place look populated. And then sprinkled around, I have some bigger ones. Let's see if I can stumble on those. Like, I got a little W shape there. This one is three foundations wide, and then I got another three wide, and a 2x3, and then another L-shaped one. So slowly I'm going to fill this place in, but for today we are just going to complete, let's say, three builds. So we got two done, guys. I'm going to take a break, and I will come back with you when I get the resources for the third one, and we'll tackle that together. I have picked this spot for our third and I think final build for this episode, guys. We're going to go ahead and do it right here. And I think I'm going to mimic roughly the style of this one, but in stone and on multiple stories. You know what I haven't brought is fence foundations. So let's go ahead and craft a couple up. How many can I make? How many of these can I make? Okay. I think I might need more than that. Let's do this. Okay, well, we'll figure it out as we go. I think the trick here is I want pillars on all the corners. So if I go ahead, you know what? No, I'm a doofus. This is going to work perfectly. So we'll do one there, one there, and one there. And I think that will give me everything I want. I've made a bunch of pillars, I believe. Yes, I have. And we're going to get started by placing those. And those are going to be, it's sort of essential to place these first, because once you've got walls in place, you can't kind of get these in all the same places. So we'll go ahead and put one of these on each of the four corners. And I think I'm going to do one back center as well. And this one is going to be like a little mock cheap version of a chimney, which is kind of cool. I think that is dead center, but these foundations give you a lot more snap points, and that can mess most people up. So let's look for our entrance. I think we're going to do it in the back here. So let's throw this stone foundation. Yeah, see that snapping here. Let's do it here where there's nothing weird to snap to. Okay, cool. We'll go ahead and throw in a reinforced door. And excellent. All right, now for the front, I think we're going to want a couple of the windowed walls, so we'll do those here and here. And actually, once the pillars are in place, you can go ahead and smash these, I believe. Yes, you can. I thought that all might come crumbling down, but I think we're good now. And these, whoops. Okay, let me go make one more of those. I'll be right back. Alright, so that was lucky. It's kind of cool that those foundations, fence foundations, stay in place even after you smash the foundation itself. That's kind of a cool effect you could get. I'll have to learn how to use that. Now this is not going to work anymore. Okay, I might have some rebuilding to do, guys. I will come back with you. Alright, so put the old foundation back. Make up for your stupid mistakes. Put this on the corner and then go ahead and destroy the fence foundation, which is what I'm about to do, right? Yeah, it looked the same. Foundation, fence foundation, whatever. So we figured out where we were gonna put our door. I guess that's in place. And now it's a matter of getting the windows on the front. So I definitely want windows on the front. And you know what? We'll do one opposite the door as well. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and use our regular walls on the ends, and I think I'm definitely going too high with this. This build is going to be a couple stories if I have planned things out right. Ooh, I might have made a mistake doing that. Let me see. We don't have to take the pillars all the way up, but I don't know if a pillar will place. No, see, it won't now that I've placed the wall, but that's okay. The only one that needs to go particularly tall is this one here, because like I said, it's going to be a mock chimney. So we'll go ahead and put that up there, and then I only have one left of the windowed walls. I'll put it over top of the door. This is gonna work fine. So I'll do a windowed wall there and a regular old wall right here, and I'll do the opposite of that on this far side, where I'll put the window over this one, but I gotta make one more window wall. Alright, y'all, so there is the beginnings of this house, and actually this is most of the house. All we've got left to do is to roof it in. So I'm gonna grab the sloped walls, a couple of sloped wooden roofs, And I think we got this thing looking the way we want it. So I'm gonna do the same thing here where I flip the texture just to get a little bit of variety, and it does make it look like a separate kind of chunk of the house. So we'll go do that, and I'll do the same thing over here. I think I gotta flip that and put it on this side. Yes, perfect. And take this and flip it. And then we're gonna do wooden roof on this place. Just because we haven't used wood at all in this build, except I suppose the door is made of wood. So let's see how, you know what, let's try and find an angle where we can actually see how this looks. I don't know if we can make sure it's lined up. No, we really can't. Okay. Okay, I got a plan, guys. I'm gonna get my newest tame, assuming how many pounds do I weigh? Ooh, that's borderline. Okay, I'm gonna unload some stuff and I'll show you my newest tame, and we will complete this build while riding him. Here he is. This is Daredevil. He is like a completely red or pinkish red Terra, and I needed a new one of those because my guy died. Lord Squishy gone forever. And sometimes there are points in a build where you just can't get high enough. I'm playing in survival and on a server. And so there's no real way to just kind of hover up here like you could if you were in a more of a creative world where you had access to admin codes. But sometimes it's the best bet to get up here is just, oh, it shifted on me at the last minute. It's a little bit off center, but whatever. You gotta deal with it. At least it's off center towards that chimney side. So we'll just go ahead and make sure we do the same thing with this other piece. Yaha, I like it. Okay, now there is a finishing touch if it's gonna work. I wanted to try out a couple of these stone railings and see if get off. There you go. Get off the bird. I'm gonna try and see if we can put those. Ooh, that would wreck a wall. So let's see what that looks like. I'll put one there, and I'm gonna go put one on the other side. And I messed around with this technique in a build I tried earlier today. And it was an all stone building and it looked kind of good. So we'll fly out and we'll take a look at this thing. All right, I think it does look okay. It gives it more of a medieval look. It feels castle-y. Really quite simple, but I like it. And so we completed this one along with two others today. This one is just small, simple, a little more wood and a little 2x1 frame. And then this one is pretty expansive. Wood and stone, four levels all in. I like it. All right, guys, that is gonna do it for this one. In today's episode, we built three small houses, and I think they turned out great. I'm glad I didn't attempt to do 10. I'm quite happy with the way these three look, especially next to that one, which is a newer build as well. That's gonna do it for this one, guys. Expect more solo episodes in the near future. It's nice to get back and hang out with you guys and take care of business. Do some building around Crags Island. I'm loving every minute of it. So thank you for watching, and I will see you all in the next episode.